लॉ ऑफ यूनिवर्सल ग्रेविटेशन। द लॉ ऑफ यूनिवर्सल ग्रेविटेशन वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय सर आइजेक न्यूटन इन द ईयर 1686। नाउ अकॉर्डिंग टू न्यूटन दिस लॉ इज ट्रू नॉट ओनली फॉर द हेवनली बॉडीज बट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू ऑफ एनी ऑफ बॉडीज इन दिस यूनिवर्स। अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस लॉ एवरी ऑब्जेक्ट इन दिस यूनिवर्स attracts every other object with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between their center. Now consider two bodies A and B. As you can see in figure, here body A has mass m1 and body B has mass m2, and they are placed with their centers at the distance r from each other, as you can see in this figure. Now, according to Newton's law of gravitation, the force of attraction exerted by body A on body B is same in magnitude but opposite in direction to the force which is exerted by body B on body A. As you can see, the direction of force F is opposite in direction. Body B is exerting force on body A and body A is exerting a force of attraction on body B, but they are in opposite directions. Now we can write this law as force F, force of attraction, is directly proportional to the product of their masses. Product of their masses, body A mass has mass m1 and body B has mass m2. m1 into m2, it is the product of masses, body A and body B. Now, force of attraction is directly proportional to the product of their masses. It means that the mass will increase, force of attraction is also increased. Directly proportional means that if one magnitude is increasing, the second amount will also increase. Number two is phenomena is force of attraction is inversely proportional to the distance between their centers. Now, as you can see, inversely proportional means that if the distance between these two objects will increase, force of attraction will decrease. Inversely proportional means that if you will increase one magnitude, one thing, that it will decrease the other force of attraction. So, force of attraction is inversely proportional to the distance between their centers. It means that the distance between body A and B is increasing, then the force of attraction will be decreasing. Now, combining equation 1 and equation 2, force is directly proportional to m1 into m2 divided by r square. Now, directly proportional sign will remove, a constant will occupy this space. F is equals to constant m1 into m2 divided by the radius r square. This proportion may be converted to an equation on multiplication by a constant G, capital G, which is called the gravitational constant. Now, if we remove constant, then our equation will become F is equals to capital G M1 into M2 divided by R square. Now, the numerical value of constant G depends on the units in which force, mass and distance are expressed. Now you can see that here the value of G is given by 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square divided by kg square. Here is the calculation of mass of Earth. How you can calculate mass of Earth by our previous formula. And that was ME, capital ME, mass of Earth is equals to gravity G, radius of Earth square divided by gravitational constant G. Now here are the all known values for our formula. Gravity, you know that 9.8 meter per second square. Gravitational constant 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square, and radius of Earth is equals to 6.4 into 10 power 6 meter. Mass of Earth is unknown. Now, by putting all these value in our formula, mass of Earth is equals to 9.8 into 6.4 into 10 power 6, and it is square, divided by 6.67 into 10 power minus 11. Now, by opening up the bracket, small bracket, 9.8 into 40.96 into 10 power 12, 6 to the 12. And we have taken from denominator 10 power minus 11, and it will become 10 power 11. Now, multiplying these two values, 9.8 into 40.96, it will become 401.408 into 10 power 23, because powers are added, divided by 6.67. Now, it will become 60.18 into 10 power 23. Now, changing the value of our decimal to write it in scientific notation, 6.018 into 10 power 23 plus 1, because if decimal changes its position towards your left, power 1, that number will be added in the power, 10 power. So our value will become 6 into 10 power 24 kg, because it is mass. So our unit will be kg. Mass of Earth will become 6.10 power 24 kg approximately. I hope that it will help you understand all these concepts. And here is your homework. Question number 1, state and explain Newton's law of gravitation. Question number 2, explain mass of Earth and determine the mass of Earth. Do the calculation in your copy. Question number 3, explain why roads are banked. Learn and write all these questions in your copy after filling the index page, and draw the diagrams where they are necessary. And they are drawn in the slides. Okay, students, thank you. Allah Hafiz.